Hi, good morning, James.
James.
How are you, buddy?
James, how are you, bud?
Good to have you back on the show.
Good to
Thank
be
you.
here. Thank you for having us,
Likewise.
man. Thank you.
Dublin's popular unscripted comedy, Impractical Jokers, is back with hilarious new episodes. I've got comedy trio Brian Q. Quinn, James Murr Murray, and Sal Vulcano, if I'm saying that right.
Absolutely, yes. I realize I don't have a nickname.
He doesn't
Well,
have
your
a
name's
nickname.
Salvatore, so
Yeah.
Sal's the nickname.
Salvatore.
Yeah.
We might even see these guys at either the RNC or the DMC early later this year. That's right. I'd love to see you at the RNC. So let's talk about your show. And now you're on TBS. Let's talk about that.
That's right. Moving on up.
Yeah.
We stayed the course for 12 years, and they said, "Why don't we see? Why don't we see how you guys do on TBS now?"
Yeah.
So if you stick around long enough, you get a promotion.
And I heard that in about 2 years we moved to Hallmark Channel.
Yeah, that's going to be exciting. That's going to be very exciting for us.
I can see a love triangle right now. Guys, let's talk a little bit. I saw the episode. There's no way that an attorney can have me sign a contract like that. Talk about
You think that now?
that.
You
You
think
think
that
that? But we
now?
play very good fake attorneys.
How much fun did you guys have doing that?
Oh my God. That particular, I mean, we have fun in general, but that particular bit was inspired by our dear friend who's also our lawyer. And we just decided to draw up these crazy contracts of people and kind of just brush over them real quick and try to get them to sign them. And those are always really fun because, we don't know what's on the page exactly. And then it's your job to get in there and like kind of just roll with it and justify what's on that page. So it's like, it's just a surreal situation to be in. So those are always really, really fun.
Do you remember? I don't think this wound up in the episode because it was too edgy, but not for us. But one of the things in the contract said that you could not be Irish or know anyone that's Irish. But we had to cut that out of the contract.
It's a good rule for life.
Yeah.
I say that as an Irishman.
Q, how did all this get started?
I ask myself that question every single day of my life. I wake up, I wonder who I am, where I am, and how did it all get started? No, I mean, we're buddies, we were doing this stuff for fun. We were making these comedy videos and putting them on YouTube way back in the day, and somebody was like, "Hey, these guys are funny. Do you have an idea for a TV show?" And we did, and they bought it. And then here we are all these years later. Yeah, it's just like us having fun, I guess. And I don't know. I can look back and I still don't know. How did it get started?
I mean, 4.5 billion years ago,
Yeah.
matter formed and
Yeah.
gravity pulled it together and created Earth and
No.
then evolution and
Yeah.
time and
Then True TV
TV
evolved. Core TV became
evolved.
True TV, and
Yeah, Core TV
Yeah.
is True
And then
TV,
they
and then we
they
came
got rid of the
out.
towing shows and the storage
Yeah.
wars and the pawn shows.
Yes.
And
And we
then
came
they took a
on.
chance on us, and
Yeah.
30, 40 years later, here we are, billionaires.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think the time has come for another towing show.
we're gonna come full circle.
Impractical
We're gonna
towing.
host a towing show next
Impractical
season.
towers.
Impractical towing, yeah.
Here's a question now, because you guys remind me of the Marx Brothers. So, speaking of the
Oh,
Marx Brothers, who's going to be Harpo? Who's going to be Groucho?
he'll be Carl.
Yeah. Karl Marx.
Karl Marx. Oh, you forgot the O.
What? I will, I will hate capitalism
Well, I
for
mean,
comedy.
when the lesser-known Marx brother, Marx.
I'll be the heavier one. He'll be the bald one.
Yeah. I'll be the
I can
social.
actually see Murr with the wig on and being Harpo. That's
Yeah.
what I want.
I can see
Yeah.
it.
I can see
Yeah.
that, yes.
Yeah. Putting hair on me any day.
Well, no, you got the eyebrows to be Groucho, I think, right?
Yeah,
You have
but
the most strong eyebrows.
yeah, I mean, I could do the mustache, I guess,
How
To
did you
all of our
guys get
viewers who don't
involved
know
with
who
Brooke
was.
Shields? Tell me how you got involved with Brooke Shields.
Well, I had written her a letter every day for 7 years. And believe it or not, so Brooke Shields' husband, our dear friend Chris Henchy, directed the Impractical Jokers movie. And so I believe that's how we initially met. Yeah. Brooke, right?
That's
Fast Friends, you know, they're just wonderful people. And they've been now in our orbit and universe of the show, the both of them now, for years. Even Chris was on the show. And, you know, it's just that's another crazy thing that we get to do that this show affords us, is to have someone as iconic as Brooke Shields come in, and we end up befriending her. And then she's someone who we see as this person for all these years. And then she comes in and she is the funniest, most down-to-earth person that, like, contributes to the show and the legacy of the show. It's just a wild thing to think about, but it is the reality of the show. And I guess after all these years, that's kind of one of the things that makes it so exciting still.
All right, last but not least, just real quick, tell us any surprises we might have, but don't give away too much for this next season.
We've got some really, really great punishments. Some very
clever
ones. I die. Yes, Sal does die.
I've been brought back to life.
Yeah.
It was an ordeal. It's going to play during sweeps week.
It's a cliffhanger episode.
I don't go back until four episodes later.
We get at Bernie Sim for three of those episodes.
I don't even know if I'm here right now, to tell you the truth.
Is that a punishment idea to Weekend and Bernie's one of us?
Well, why don't we take it to the writer's room and let him do the interview?
Okay.
Yeah. Guys, Brian Q, Quinn, James Murray, and Sal, thank you so much for joining us on Morning Blend.
Thank you.
I love it every time you're on the show, and I love what you guys do on Impractical Jokers. Keep doing it. Thank you.
Thanks, buddy. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.